there are resources that come in, food and water and energy, and then wastes that go out. And that flow of inputs and outputs, we call that the urban metabolism.
Without the countryside, there's no food, there's no incoming labor for migration. So urban centers absolutely depend on their surrounding areas. Surrounding areas depend on the city too, because that's the market for their products. So rather than seeing an adversarial relationship between cities and the countryside, what we really should see is that those two worlds are completely integrated.
When you have a city and you have an urban metabolism, you can think about the waste generation as the problem you need to manage. The bigger the city, the more waste you generate and the more inputs you also need to operate the city. And we can think about efficiency as that measure from inputs to outputs. A more efficient city needs fewer inputs to operate itself and therefore generates fewer outputs as well. So efficiency is a way to reduce the waste stream.
So cities are increasingly important because they're efficient places for the delivery of needed goods and services. Rather than wasteful or using up resources, you can actually use cities as an efficient delivery mechanism for the many, many different things that people need in concentrated spaces.
We have gotten better at our urban metabolism in many places. Buildings are more efficient, cars are more efficient, that kind of thing. However, the cities have also become bigger at the same time. So the total flow has increased in most places.